Many of the great and good of English football gathered at Old Trafford to celebrate the work of the Bobby Moore Fund over the last 20 years.
The Bobby Moore Fund is a crucial part of our fundraising portfolio. It's vitally important to the overall ambition of Cancer Research UK. It raises both awareness in audiences that we otherwise wouldn't speak to, so predominantly men, obviously, and it's also been responsible for raising over £20 million for our life-saving research.
Bobby Moore can be considered as one of the greatest footballers of all time, with 108 appearances and a World Cup winners' medal. He sadly passed away in 1993. His wife Stephanie set up the Bobby Moore Fund to help with bowel cancer and cancer research.
Bowel cancer is the second highest killing cancer in this country, with 44 men and women dying every day from this disease.
Throughout his career, Bobby Moore was known as one of the greatest defenders of his generation and equally respected off the field.
He was a gentleman and was always, you know, in our family, regarded as such by my father and my grandfather, who watched him play and were as synonymous with his character as he was with his playing, you know, his outstanding playing ability. So, and it's wonderful now that this campaign, through Stephanie's hard work, continues to keep his name in the spotlight.
His name will always be great. His name will always be special. But to add this on top of it, then the fact that you were known as a great man, the only man who won the World Cup, but also the guy who started this fantastic information service, because that's what it will become, it will save, hopefully, many thousands of people's lives.
Over the last 20 years, money has been raised by the charity and has helped to fund valuable research and also continues to raise awareness of bowel cancer.
The most important thing the general public can do is to help themselves. It's to look, it's to be aware of bowel cancer. The biggest danger in Britain is that, you know, for all our bullishness, we're kind of quite shy at addressing some of the things that are described as personal. And, you know, I'm bold enough to say, look at your poo. You know, you've got to say that in public. And some people sort of shy away from that. And when I see people shying away at an event, I say, no, look, tomorrow. And ask your dad to look, because it might just save his life.
I'm Thomas Deegan, reporting for Keys TV News, Trafford.